the first thing that you need to do in order to put yourself in a position of power is to change your goal, right? A lot of women come to us and their goal is to get this guy. They're like, I need to get him, right? And you need to switch your goal from the guy that you want to the relationship that you want. Because the relationship, in my opinion, is far more important than the guy, right? A relationship where you're seen, where you're valued, where a man gives you the things that you want. He gives you the relationship that you want, the relationship that you deserve, the relationship that a woman like you should have, right? A committed relationship, a relationship where a guy says, I'm all in this, and I'm not leaving, and you're amazing, and I think that you're one of the most amazing women that I've ever met in my life, and I love you, and I want to be committed to you for life, right? That's the situation that you should be in. And so some women decide that the man is more important. If that's your decision, that's fine. However, I think that you should put the relationship and having the relationship that you want above the man. So switch the goal. The second thing that you need to start doing is start dating other people. Start dating other men. And this is how you get abundance. And so it's one of the pillars. I'm going to be putting out a program here pretty soon in the next couple of weeks, a new program. It's going to be awesome. One of the pillars of that program is abundance. The abundance principle. Abundance principle. And the abundance principle, it's something that you can't rationalize. It's something that you can't visualize. It's something that you have to experience. And the only way you can experience it is by actually having abundance in your life. And so you need to go and start dating other men and create an orbit of men around you who want to be in a relationship with you. That way, once you come back to this situation that you're in, you're not afraid of it blowing up or him disappearing or whatever, because you have an abundance of men already. And I can't tell you how important this is. A lot of women in our community want to skip this step. They just want to focus on him and manipulate him into doing it. And I'm telling you, do the abundance approach. That's where your power comes from. The third step here. The third thing that you want to do is stop sleeping with him, stop kissing him, and stop putting yourself in positions to do these things with him. And from now on, from now until the end of time, do not get into a sexual relationship with a man if you haven't talked about two things. The first thing being what he's looking for in a relationship. Because most guys will be honest, and if they aren't looking for something long-term, they'll be confused, they'll tell you they don't know what they want, they'll tell you all kinds of stupid things, and so you don't end up hooking up with a guy like that. And the second thing that you want to talk about is exclusivity and being exclusive with him. And I talk about that in some of the other videos that I have, but you want to make sure that you have a conversation with him about exclusivity so that you don't end up getting into a situation where he's seeing other people while he's sleeping with other people while you're sleeping with him, because of all kinds of different ramifications, from diseases to him having the power in the situation because you didn't talk about it, and so he's running around hooking up with other people, and that's not what ultimately leads you to having the relationship that you really want. One of the things that I say a lot is friends with benefits is not a stage from meeting a guy to marriage. Most friends with benefits, they've done studies on casual relationships, and they found that casual relationships, 1 in 3 times, only potentially have the ability to move to a serious relationship. And so my suggestion is that you don't ever get into one of those situations ever again. Never be in that situation, because it pulls your power down, and you're giving him all these things, but you're not getting what you really want in return. And so don't sleep around. Don't get into situations where you're in a friends with benefits relationship or casual relationship or whatever. Don't do that ever again. Okay? So, and then the last thing that you need to do is communicate with him. Because if you just pull back and stop doing all these things, he's going to be like, what is she doing? Right? I don't get it. And, you know, he's going to be confused and frustrated. And he's going to be like, why aren't you talking to me about this? And so what you need to do is you need to let him know that you've decided that you don't want a casual relationship anymore. And that means, and that he means a lot to you. You need to tell him that he means a lot to you. You need to tell him that you really like him. You need to tell him that you have feelings for him and that you think he's a very special person in your life and that you'd love to have a real committed relationship with him. However, that you need to make sure that you're getting what you want as well, and it's not fair to you to have you in a casual relationship with him. And so tell him what you'd like him to have and have those conversations about exclusivity and what he's looking for again, and make sure that you don't sleep with him again unless he's willing to verbally confirm to you that he's looking for the type of relationship that you want and that he's going to be exclusive with you. And if he's not willing to do that, that's okay. That's why we talk about having the abundance thing in the first place. That way you're not like, oh my God, you know, stuck on him, right? You have an abundance of men, you're connecting with other men, you're meeting with other, dating other men and starting kind of these situations with other men so that you can occupy your time, so that you can connect with other guys, so that you can find a guy who is willing to really give you what it is that you want, because it's very possible that he's going to say, no, look, here's what we did, what we agreed to from the beginning. I just wanted to be in a casual relationship. I'm not ready for something real. And there's a very good possibility that he might say that. And there's a very good possibility that he might say that he doesn't want to lose you and that he wants to keep you in his life. And what ends up happening a lot of times is guys will end up saying, no, I just wanted a casual relationship. And the woman says, fine, that's cool. I'm going to go see other people and I don't want to continue this anymore. And then the guy ends up coming back and being like, okay, you know, like I really miss you and I really want to have you in your life, in my life, and I'm willing to give you what you want. And you don't want to be in a situation where he doesn't say that, and you absolutely have to be willing to walk away. The most powerful position that you can possibly be in is a position of abundance and a position where you're willing to walk away. And if you do those things and you're serious about it and you're not just bluffing, you're not just giving him some kind of ultimatum and then stay with him regardless, that's a position of power, and you're far more likely to get what you want than if you end up just faking it or trying to force it or whatever other kind of crappy tactics are out there that women use these days. So remember, don't force it. Put yourself in a position of power. The best position of power is a position where you have abundance and a willingness to walk away.